3, amen.
Yes.
Of the Miracle Hope Missionary Church, amen. Where you got the hope, amen. God got the miracle.
Amen.
We're located at 3919 Lockwood and Crane, amen. Amen. And we're grateful, amen, for everything that God has done, amen. Amen. We thank God for what he's doing. All honor and praise go to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Yes, sir.
Listen to this, y'all. He's the shepherd. Yeah. I'm the under shepherd, amen. In the name of Jesus, amen. Thank you, amen. We are just grateful, amen. If you don't mind, turn with me to Jeremiah, amen. Jeremiah, the 29th chapter, amen.
All right, all right.
Some of you have heard this one before, amen, but God wants to go in a different direction, amen. Amen, that you can be blessed and you can be healed by it. You can be changed by it, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Jeremiah 29 chapter, amen. Verse number 11. Amen.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Amen. As we are getting ready to end the year 2021, amen. And go into the year 2020, amen. There's some things, amen, that we as Christians need to be aware of, amen.
All right.
Thank you, Villatilla, amen. As he amen. Come and say that he spoke to us, amen. I thank you for him being focused, amen, because we know the Spirit of God should bless you to get even more focused.
Yes, sir.
Because we're getting ready to close out 1 year, but we're getting ready to walk into a brand new year.
Amen.
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 And God already have a plan.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
God already has a plan. Amen.
Yes, sir.
I'm grateful that God has a plan, amen, but I want you to make sure, amen, that you line up with God's plan and not your own plan. Amen.
Jeremiah, the 29th chapter, amen, controlling, amen, amen, they right there, amen. Jeremiah, the 29th chapter, amen, amen, there you go. Jeremiah, the 29th chapter, verse number 11,
amen. It reads in this manner, amen. Looking around the room, looks like everybody got their Bible open and everybody is focused, amen, where we need to go. Jeremiah, the 29th chapter, verse number 11. For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, said the Lord. Thoughts of peace, not of evil. To give you an expected end. Amen. Some people that might not understand this, let me read another version of the same thing. Jeremiah 29:11, say, For I know the plan that I have for you, declared the Lord, a plan to prosper you, not to harm you. A plan to give you hope and a future. Amen. God has put in my heart today about a plan for the future. Amen. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
The preacher don't preach about it.
The preacher don't preach about
a plan.
Plan.
For the future.
For the future.
Neighbor.
Neighbor.
If you like it or not.
If you like it or not.
We all need a plan.
We all need a plan.
For the future.
For the future.
Neighbor.
Neighbor.
The preacher gonna make it clear.
The preacher gonna make it clear.
With only 33 days left.
With only 33 days left.
We need a plan.
We need a plan.
For the future.
For the future.
You can be seated. I made sure I brought that number 33 in there. Yeah. Some of y'all might not understand what 33 means and what it says, amen. But Jesus came to the earth for 33 long years.
Yes, sir. Yes, he did.
And he came with a plan.
Yes, he did.
Amen.
Yes, he did.
And if you look at your calendar, amen.
All right.
December got 31 days in it.
All right.
And how many days are left in the month of November?
2 days.
And if you take the 2 and add it with the 31, how many days you got there?
33.
Yes, sir. So we got 33 days. But we're not just planning for the year 2021.
All right.
We need to be planning for the future.
Yes, sir.
Can I help somebody? Amen.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Yeah. Because as children of God, God already have a plan for each and every one of us.
All right.
What we need to do is get in line with God's plan.
That's it. That's it.
Too often we got our own plan of how we want to handle things,
uh-huh.
How we want to do things,
yes, sir.
But we got to stay focused on God's plan. Can I help somebody?
Please.
Amen. Because I need you to get clarity today. Amen. His plan is not any kind of plan. Okay. Let's deal with this. Psalms 1 have a small taste of what the plan is all about. Psalms 1 has a small direction of what the plan is all about. If I can get you to turn your Bible to Psalm 1, because I need you to understand God has a plan for you. Amen?
Amen.
We talked about bless as we sung our song. Amen. Amen. I had my brother, he was singing his bless, bless, bless. Amen. And somebody need to understand, no matter what you're going through,
you're blessed.
You're blessed.
Yes, sir.
It may not always look good, but you're blessed.
Blessed.
Yeah. The Bible says everything works for the good of those that love the Lord, that are called according to his purpose.
Amen.
That means sometimes things that look like it's bad is really good.
Really good. Yes, sir.
In the
yes,
name sir. Of Jesus. Yes, amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. I need you to understand that God is working it out. All you got to do is stay with his plan.
Amen.
Look. Psalm 1 starts off and say, blessed the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of scoffers. But look, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in the law he meditate day and night. If I get somebody to have a relationship with God day and night, I've said it before, have Jesus for breakfast, because Jesus could not. Amen. Amen. See, I need you to meditate on the word. Don't just read it. Amen. There's a difference between reading and meditation. Amen. Amen. You can read the word. Amen. And don't get nothing from it. But if you meditate on the word, there's a whole bunch that you will be blessed with inside the word that you didn't see before because you meditated on it. I like to use this one all the time. Amen. 23rd number of Psalms starts off, the Lord is my shepherd. What did it say? Scripture says, I shall not want. But when I meditate on it, this is what it says to me. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. And if I got a problem with want, I ain't letting the Lord be my shepherd.
Amen.
That's meditation. That's meditation. If I'm meditating on the word, I'm going to get something deeper than the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. So if I'm letting him be my shepherd, there is nothing that I'm going to ever want because him being my shepherd will always take care of my needs in the name of Jesus. All I got to do is let him be my shepherd. Somebody will get that later on. Amen. As you go to the house, amen. Back to Psalm 1. Because we're talking about a plan. Can I help you?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. We're talking about a plan for the future. Verse number 3 says, he shall be like a tree planted by the river of water that bring forth his fruit when in his season. Leaves shall not wither. Paul come around and leaves start withering, but if you walking with the Lord, amen. If you walking with the Lord, amen.
Yes, sir.
There might be a season called fall for man.
Yeah.
But nothing ain't gonna fall for you, amen.
Yes,
you don't hear what I'm saying? James 1 say, if you fall down, count it all joy. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Count it all joy. Amen. Amen. Because God is getting ready to work. Count it all joy. Get happy. Amen. When things start going wrong, start praising God. Amen. Because there's a blessing in it for you. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Somebody, this ain't the same season. God lived in a different season than man.
Yeah.
Man got summer, spring, winter, and fall. Amen. But God lived in a different. God's season can bless you. Summer, spring, winter, and fall. Amen. The weather might change, but his season
blessing. Yes,
sir. Can I help somebody?
Go ahead.
The next verse get even crazy. Ungodly are not so like a child with the wind drives away.
Yes, sir.
But I gotta get to verse 5 because that's where. Verse 5 says, listen, therefore the ungodly shall stand in the judgment, nor sin in the congregation of the righteous. The Lord loveth the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. I'm going to go back and mess with this because I got to get y'all to get this. This is important. This is important. Verse number 3, I won't mess with it one more time. And he shall be like a tree planted by the river of water that bring forth his fruit and his leaf, and his leaves shall not wither. But look at the last one. And whatsoever? And whatsoever? Whatsoever? COVID-19 show up? That's whatsoever. Amen. Amen. Money gets funny? That's whatsoever. Amen. Things ain't going right. Amen. Amen. The spouse, amen, giving you a hard time. Whatsoever. Amen. The children ain't going. The job ain't going the way you were. Look at this right there. Whatsoever. He do it. Shall prosper. Can I help somebody? Because we're working on a future plan. See, I got to get you to line up with the future plan. Can I help somebody today?
No.
If I can get you to line up with the future plan, it's not the people that use you. Because sometimes it's not a use me. Sometimes we get upset because people tend to misuse us. But if God told me to bless them, I'll bless them anyhow. Listen to this. It's not the person use me or use men, but it's the movement that God got going on at that time. That if you allow God to do what he said to, he said, if they slap one cheek, turn, oh Lord, then mercy, turn, oh Lord, say, turn, oh Lord, I can't get it out. I'm struggling, I can't get it out, believe me. He said, return one, hit one cheek, amen, turn, oh Lord, you got it, I'm struggling, amen, in the name of Jesus, amen. He said, if they take your coat, give them your cloak, amen. I'm struggling, believe me, amen, in the name of Jesus, amen. But his word will bless you in obedience to his word, because he got a plan for the future.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen. Slap one on my cheek, you think I'm getting ready to turn the other one? Are you serious? Amen. 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 Somebody say he gave you two cheeks for a reason. Lord have mercy. Amen. You better start praying. Amen. I need to be praying, and you need to be praying. You slap the first cheek. Amen. In the name. Believe it. I can't get it out. Amen. Because I'm struggling with it. Amen. Amen. But the future plan is obedience is better than sacrifice.
Yeah.
They can use you and abuse you. But there's a movement. Can I help you? Can I help you?
Go ahead.
The movement, if you're obedient, said it will be that you will be the head and not the tail. Oh Lord, that sounds good to me. Amen. Amen.
Part.
Amen. Wait. I gotta deal with the head and tail. Amen. Amen. Because the dog come, amen. And he wags his tail when he's happy. Amen.
Come on,
amen.
Come on,
amen. But he got to eat something with his head. Amen. Yes. His eyes see with his head. Amen. He eat with his head. You don't hear what I'm saying. Amen. His tail get wagging when he get happy. Amen. But guess what? When the head got something to eat. Amen. When the head can see good. Amen. When the head is being blessed. Amen. Hallelujah.
Somebody
going to
get that later on. Amen.
He said, I'll be the head and not the tail. Amen. Amen. The tail, amen. Wagging, and get them happy. And it's over with, amen. But guess what? The head, amen, will keep the tail wagging all the time. If the head is the best one, amen. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I'm talking about plans.
That's all right. That's all right.
For the future.
That's all right.
Can I help somebody?
Go ahead.
Amen. Because some of them are going, he said you'd be the little. Not a
boy.
Can I deal with that? Because if I'm borrowing, I say, Lord, your word says I'm supposed to be limited, not a borrower. So look at this. Look at this. Plan for the future. Say, Lord, what am I doing wrong? Because your word will not return to you, boy. Yeah. Your word will not return to you, boy, but accomplish everything that you said. So what am I doing wrong? See, because sometimes in your plans for the future, you got to make sure you check yourself before you wreck yourself. Because God got a blessing for you, amen. But you want to go about doing it your way, amen. And your way can get it in the way of the blessing that God has already told you. Pastor, what in the world are you talking about? If you're living, you should be learning. Anybody that's constantly living should be learning. And if you ain't learning, you really ain't living. Can I help somebody? Amen. Because you need to get that today. Amen. If you're living in Christ Jesus, you ought to constantly be learning. And the more you learn, the more you apply.
That's right.
Minister Kelly read it in Isaiah. made it clear that God will bless you in the middle of the desert. He said he will take your crooked road and make it straight.
Yes, sir.
In the name of Jesus. I know he can do that. Because he not seen it, amen.
Yes.
Amen. And it's scary, amen.
Yes,
amen, because
yes,
I'm walking more and more like Christ than I ever walked before, and Lord knows I don't even want to talk about my past, amen. But I know he done delivered me from, and he ain't delivered me from no one day, Roberto, amen. Amen, I put the crown raw bottle down 26 years ago, amen, and haven't touched it since. Somebody got to hear what I'm saying, amen. I don't know what adultery and fornication is, amen. She's not just the first lady, she's the only lady. Y'all don't hear what I'm saying in the name of Jesus, amen. If you keep walking with God, amen, there's something that's going to happen, amen. In the name of, you're going to start shaking it off, amen. You're going to start shaking it off, amen. And you just keep walking with God. I'm talking about a plan.
Yeah.
Let me help you, amen. Can I give you a biblical character, amen?
Yeah.
Go with me.
Acts.
The ninth chapter. I need you to give with me a biblical character, amen. I need you to deal with me a biblical character. That was actually doing his own thing, amen.
Oh.
Amen, come on. He was doing his own thing, amen. All right, Yolanda, amen, talk to you loud, amen. He was actually doing his own thing, amen. He was a child of the king,
all right,
amen. But he was doing his own thing, amen. Because I need to help somebody there. There's a plan for the future. There's only 33 days left,
yes,
in the year 2021.
Right.
I got things written on my mirror, amen. And plans I made for 2021. Some of those things I have accomplished. Haven't accomplished them all, amen. I was looking at the mirror and said, okay, what happened here and what happened there? And the thing I said, was that my plan? Or was that God's plan? Can I help somebody? Amen. Because there's some things on there I have accomplished, amen.
Right.
But I haven't accomplished them yet, amen. As we get ready to go into the big business world, amen.
Yes,
this is what happened with me at working at GE, amen. They would call us in, amen. In December, amen. But we can make a plan for next year, amen.
Right.
They call it your goals for next year.
Right.
Inside those goals, it was things that they expected to be better with in 2022 than you was in 2021.
Right.
Amen. There's something I need to focus on being better in 2022 than in 2021. In 2021, he protected me from the COVID-19 virus. In 2021, he made sure the Delta virus didn't touch me, amen. And if he did something for me, I ought to do something for him, amen. In the name of Jesus. So in 2022, I got to do better than I did in 2021.
Amen. Amen.
GE would make us come in. We would have to set goals. Amen. And the goals would have to be something that improved you. But it really improved GE too. You was living, but listen to this, you was learning at the same time. Amen. Something may consist of you going back to school. Amen. On certain subjects. Amen. Yeah. I'm trying to help somebody. Because as Christians, there's a future plan.
Amen.
That God has for all of us.
Yes, sir.
And we need to line up with his plan.
Yes, sir.
Too often we got our own plan. The need I look at those things on the mirror, amen. And I say, I accomplished that, but that I didn't accomplish that, I didn't accomplish. What happened?
Huh?
Was that?
Yes, sir.
My plan? Or was that God's plan?
Yeah.
You with me? Ask the ninth chapter, amen. Amen. Whatever GE did, amen. GE brought me in, amen. And they had a conversation with me, and I wrote my goals down of what I was going to do in 2022, amen. They always wanted it in writing, amen.
Uh-huh.
And you need to put your goals in writing.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, because the Bible says in the book of Habakkuk, amen, write it down, amen. Make a vision, amen,
yes,
that you can see it, amen. And guess what? A family without a plan is on their way to destruction. The brothers say, I got to stay focused.
Amen.
Because there's a calling in my life.
Yes, sir.
I don't fully understand it, but I gotta stay focused.
Yes, sir.
And it's not easy to stay focused. They got too much distraction all around them.
Yeah.
It's not easy to stay focused.
Yeah.
Problem over here, problem over there.
Yeah.
It's clear in the King James Version, the word problem don't even exist. Amen. In the name of Jesus. God ain't nothing that God can't heal. Can I help you?
Okay.
Acts, the 9th chapter. I've been trying to get you there. Amen. I know. There's a person called Saul. He even went to the priest to ask priest for instruction because he wants to. Jonathan, he wants to go after the Christian and imprison him. This is Saul. He goes to the priest, and let's write that in the scripture, amen. Read it for yourself. Don't get mad with me, amen. Amen, because I'm saying it, amen. It's real, amen. And Saul, yet breeding and threatening, and clamors against the disciples of the Lord, went unto the high priest, yeah, and desired a letter to Damascus, to the synagogue, if he would follow any of his way, whether they were men or women, he might bring them bound unto Jerusalem. And he had his plan. But can I help you? Verse 3 says, as he journeyed, he came near Damascus. I wanted to say it was Damascus, but it really was darkness. Amen. And suddenly there shined round about him a light from heaven, and fell to his knees, and he heard a voice saying, Saul, Saul, why persecute thou me? And your plan needs to line up with God's plan. Because if not, God will get your attention. Amen. Amen. God said, I go and prepare a place for you. Where I am, Jonathan, he'll be there also. Can I help somebody? In order for you to do that, you got to have a plan. A husband and wife, we need to have a plan.
Amen.
Yeah. You might nail that plan by yourself, amen. Amen. Because what the husband and wife want to do as a couple may not be what you need to do as an individual.
Amen.
But there needs to be a plan. God said, I prepare a place for you. And where I am, you will be awful. But the only people that's going to go to the same place that God's going is people that are prepared people with a prepared plan. And the prepared plan is to walk into the feasts of God and be obedient. 33 days left in the year 2021. Jesus came and walked on earth for 33 long years. He had a plan.
Yes, sir. Yes, he did.
Can I help somebody? Because there's somebody in here. They looking all forward to a New Year's Eve party.
Huh?
Yeah. But there's some things, amen, that I did in the year 2021 that need to stay in 2021.
Yes, sir.
There's some things that I did in 2021 need to stay right there. I ain't taking it with me.
Uh-huh.
In 2022.
Amen.
Amen.
Bye-bye.
We went through the cabinet at our house and everything that had a expired expiration date. Yeah. They got something for the expired expiration date.
Exactly.
Yeah. That you've been carrying for a long period of time.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And that stuff with the expired expiration date needs to be in the expired category. Amen. Because it's expired. Amen. But you trying to take the expired stuff, amen, and use it anyhow, and you wondering why you keep getting sick, you wondering why you keep having trouble, you wondering why you keep struggling, amen. But it said expired, amen, and you need to leave it in the year 2021, amen, and you make a plan for the year 2022, amen, just 33 days left, amen. Get it done, amen. Before the end of the year, amen. Because it's between you and the Lord, amen. Just 33 days left, amen. He wandered on the earth for 33 and a half long years, amen. The Bible says one day with the Lord is but 1,000 years. And 1,000 years is but one day. So in the name of Jesus, there's somebody here.
Yeah.
Woo! Somebody here. Can you go look at this one?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Plan for the future.
Absolutely.
Yeah, yeah. God is changing. Amen. I used to make a plan for the year, but he said plan for the future. Here Saul had a plan to go and take Christians and imprison them.
Yeah.
But you can't mess with God, people.
Okay.
God knocked him off. Amen. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Has somebody out of you what I'm saying? You got to learn to be obedient. enemies, amen. The one of those scriptures we love them, amen. Just try to love somebody to death, amen. Amen, love them to death, amen. Amen, they ain't wondering why. They know you, they have treated you wrong, but you keep loving them, amen. They know they ain't treating you right, amen, but they keep loving you, amen. In the name of Jesus, amen. I dare you to love them to death, amen. They'll be around there scratching their head, amen. Amen. In the name of Jesus, amen. I didn't do it right, but you still being kind to me, amen. I didn't say good things about it, but you still being kind to me, in the name of Jesus. And God will continue with you. They will make you an enemy. You push through. Push through is what I have on my lounge chair when I kick back, amen. And then rise my foot up in the sky, amen. That mean my enemies, amen, will come, amen, and bless me at my feet, amen. In the name of Jesus, amen. Somebody got to hear what I'm saying. I'm talking about making a plan, amen, for the future, amen. Saul was going in the wrong direction. God knocked him off his beat, amen. In the name of Jesus, then he sent the right people around him, amen. The people that were following Jesus Christ. And you got to make sure that you're around the right people, amen. We're taking around the wrong people, amen. Let the drug dealers be the drug dealers. Let the alcoholics be the alcoholics. Let the adulterers be the adulterers. In the name of Jesus, stop gossiping, amen. In the name of Jesus, if you will pray with me on the phone, we don't need to talk, amen. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Jesus got through with Saul. Saul was on his way to go take care of the Christians.
Yeah.
And he could preach with them.
Yes, sir.
And teach with them.
Yes, sir.
In the name of Jesus. And when God get through with you, amen, you better stay focused. Amen. He makes it clear.
Yeah.
That faith.
That works.
The size. No.
Yeah.
Of a grain of mustard.
All right.
You don't have to have the whole.
Not that much. Just
a grain of mustard.
Yes, sir.
It can move mountains.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
You gotta believe God's word.
All right.
When everything else is not working.
Yes, sir.
I like Hebrews 11 chapter. They say now.
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 Now. I've learned the word of my now is not your life. Amen. Now faith is the substance of things hoped for. There are other things not seen. But when I meditate on the word now, I took the word now and I spelled it backwards. Amen. In the name of Jesus, somebody will get this. Amen. Take now. Amen. It's old subject. Amen. And I meditate on it. Amen. When I meditated, God showed me the word now. Amen. When you took it forward. Amen. But I dare you to take it backwards. Amen. It's spelled W-O-N. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If I come to my now, amen, I have already won. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Of being hopeful. There is a thing not to faith, amen. In the name of Jesus, you can't praise God unless you're walking by faith, amen. There's something you don't see, but in the name of Jesus, I'm walking in it anyhow. The God's word says so. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Tired on Sunday, but I'm going to show up in it.
Amen.
You don't hear what I'm saying, amen. Because I'm going to praise God anyhow. Amen.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus. Yeah.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Can I help you? Jesus was on a journey. 33 and a half long years. Yeah. Saul. But Jesus was on a journey. Yeah. For 33 and a half long years. Can I help somebody today? Amen. Because I need to help you to understand. Amen. There's a plan for the future. Amen. Jesus knew what his plan was. Amen. And in the struggle of your plan, amen, something's going to happen. Amen. We're getting ready to celebrate Christmas. Amen. They want to say that he was born on Christmas Day. Amen. Y'all need to get that straight. Amen.
No.
He was born. Yeah. It wasn't Christmas Day. Amen. But he was born in a manger. Amen. On a 33 year, he was on a future plan. Amen.
Yeah.
For me and for you. Amen. When he was born, and he could have been born in Methodist Hospital. Amen. He could have been born in St. Luke. Amen. But he decided to be born in a manger. Amen.
Yeah.
Somebody got to hear what I'm saying.
Yes, amen.
There was no room for him in the end. Amen. I pray that you got ready.
wasn't born with us by any kind, but he was born by a virgin, amen. A virgin called Mary, amen. Had a step with a man before, amen. In the name of Jesus, that God needed us to be clean and pure. In the name of Jesus, he wandered on the earth for 33 long years, amen. Let me help you, amen. There was a little girl, amen, 12 years old that had passed away, amen. But on his journey, amen, he touched that 12-year-old girl, amen, and gave her life where there was no life, amen. He touched her body, amen. In the name of Jesus, there were one that had been struggling for 12 long years, amen. She went to the doctor, amen. She went to the pharmacist, amen. Got her prescription drugs, amen. But in the name of Jesus, it wasn't working. But Jesus showed up. Thank you, Lord. 33 and a half long years. There was a man by the pool of Bethesda. They ain't been there going there for 38 long years. He was trying to get in the pool.
Yes, sir.
Because if he go in the pool, he got healed. But Jesus showed up, and then somebody got a plan, amen. Amen. They're trying to get to the pool of water right now, amen. Yes, but I know a man called Jesus, amen. Yes. If you just took the hymn of the God, amen. In the name of Jesus, yes. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Let's take it a little bit higher, amen. There were 10 men with leprosy, amen. In the name of Jesus, amen. They seen Jesus, amen. Got excited at the shout, amen. And started shouting out the name Jesus, amen. Thank you, Lord. He said, all of you, go to the priest because you're healed. God can speak and things will happen in the name of Jesus. Let me show you how powerful God is. The more I meditate on this, the more it blows my mind.
All right.
Everybody said he liked to be the one that came back. God was more concerned about the nine that didn't come back. When Jesus showed up, when the one showed up, Jesus said, wasn't there 10?
Yeah.
And where's the nine? And God is concerned. This is my way of saying. About me and you. He's concerned about the nine. That the nine know if you start planning your future right now.
Yes, sir.
Thank God for the house. Thank God for the car.
Yes.
Thank God for the business.
Yes, sir.
Thank God for all the materialistic stuff.
Yeah, no, God.
But if you start planning your future,
yes,
to do what's right,
yes, sir,
in the sight of God. Amen.
Yeah.
If you start planning your future, amen, to wake up in the morning, amen, saying thank you, Jesus,
thank
amen.
You, Lord.
Have Jesus for breakfast, amen.
Yeah.
Kiss Jesus good night, amen.
Yes,
if you wake up, amen, knowing it was God and God alone, amen, thank you, Lord. 33 and a half long years, he was unhurt. Listen to this, y'all. Because of my sin and yours, he knew what he had to do. That we can plan our future to be with him one day. In the name of Jesus, I don't know where you are, but in the name of Jesus, I may not be in a hurry to pass away.
All right.
But when my time comes,
yes, sir,
I know I'm going to a better place.
Yes.
Y'all hear what I'm saying? Sometimes the old knees start to hurt. Sometimes the hands start to hurt.
Yeah.
The doctor said that was arthritis.
Yes.
I ain't got time to deal with altar, amen. In the name of Jesus, amen. Altar need to leave me alone, amen. I'm still going to do the word of the Lord,
amen.
In the name of Jesus, y'all going to hear what I'm saying, amen. Because I got a plan. It's not my plan, but it's God's plan. And there's somebody in here, amen. I got to help you, amen. He died on a Friday, amen. But your sins and mine, amen. For that could be a conversion, amen. That I could leave some things behind, amen.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord. And I could move forward, amen. Doing what the Lord had called me to do. He died on a Friday, amen. But guess what? He didn't stay dead, amen. Because early, Sunday morning, he got up with all powers in his hand. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Who I have any believers in the house? Anybody believe? If he died and rose
Amen.